By the way, you're not serious.
Clearly, you don't know me. Honestly, you don't know me. Look, I don't know. I'm in love with Cindy. Yes, as in she just moves me. She fills up the space in me. You feel me, right?
Are you the one talking? Are you the one talking? You can't be the one talking. What?
No. I'm serious. You know, and I'll just keep thanking you, you know, for picking us up and, you know, matchmaking us. I'll keep thanking you for that.
So, the great and eligible Matt Johnson is in love.
Yes, and also very happy about it.
Good for you.
Very happy about it.
Good for you. I'm happy.
Guess what?
What?
I have a surprise for you. Just a little token of my appreciation for hooking us up.
For me?
Yes. All of it for you.
200 grand.
Yes. Just spend it, okay? Go shopping, buy yourself some nice things. Just spend it, courtesy of me, okay?
You're really serious. You're really serious.
Just spend
Thank you.
It.
All right.
You don't have to thank me, okay? I should be the one thanking you for bringing us together. Just spend the money.
I hope you're serious. I hope you're not jiving me. I hope you're serious about being in love with my friend.
I am in love.
Hello? Cindy?
Cleo? Is my boyfriend in your house?
How did you know? Matt is here with me, making me happy in a cash kind of way.
My boyfriend is in your house. He did not mention that to me.
Maybe he forgot. So, how far now? Have you finished doing what you wanted to town to do?
Cleo, I just saw my boyfriend's car parked in front of your house. That is why I'm making this call.
Come right in then. Let's pop some champagne, girl. Yeah, it's open. Come in. Your girl is here.
Yeah. I thought as much. I just heard you on the phone. Gosh, and I was just about leaving.
Meaning? Wait and give your girl a hug. Huh?
All right, I will.
Of course you'll do that. I'm coming. Let me drop my money in the bedroom. Whoops.
Hello? Wait, are you guys trying to keep a secret from me? Come on, girl, out with it.
Matt just gave me 200,000 naira.
Really? Oh, wow, that's nice. Come here. That's really generous.
It's okay, it's...
Nice, thank you.
It's no big deal, okay? I'll just leave you girls to catch up on gist. Alright?
Okay.
Alright, baby?
Alright.
Have a nice day. Alright, you too. Bye, love. Alright. Bye. My dear. 200,000 naira. Just like that. Now, am I lucky or what?
Yeah. You're very lucky.
Sorry.
So, can I have my share?
Your share? It's my money, not yours. I can give you a cut, yes, but not share.
Cut, share, whatever you call it. I really don't care. As long as it is 50-50.
Meaning?
My boyfriend gave you money without informing me. Now that is not right.
Stop being ridiculous, I beg, Cindy. I introduced you to Matt. I knew Matt long before I matchmade the two of you. So what's all this rubbish about informing you first before giving me money?
Now, don't forget whose boyfriend he is now, Cleo. Mine, not yours. I will not sit here and allow him throw money around when he can do important things with it. I will not leave this place until I get back half of his money. 100 grand.
Wait. Cindy, which one is your problem there now? Is it that Matt gave me money? Or that he gave me money without informing you? Or that you want to share it 50-50? Which is it?
All of the above.
Well, no. I, Cleopatra, will not give you a dime. And Matt is free to come and go as he pleases in my house without informing you first. Because he was my close pal long before I introduced him to you. Do I make myself clear?
Guys, we're best of friends.
Oh, please leave friendship out of this, okay? We girls, we know how we handle our friendship. It doesn't last, so leave that out. Can you imagine? Wait, this girl has the nerves to call my own boyfriend to report me to him. For what now?
Baby.
Eh? No, is it because she introduced you to me? What is that supposed to mean now?
Baby,
is she
down.
The first person to
calm
do
down,
people?
Please, calm down.
No, wait, okay? I don't get it. Is it because she hooked us up? Does that give her the right to think she could be some fairy godmother to me? And you. You went and lavished money on her without even telling me first.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, I know this was all my fault, okay? I caused all this. I'm sorry about it. Please, please, I'm sorry.
And you should stop being close to Cleo. I mean, I'm your girlfriend here. Yeah? You should put me first.
Fine, I'll do that. Alright? Please, I'll do that, okay? Alright? I'm sorry.
Then stop giving her money. She's not done anything to deserve it. With or without her, we would have still met if we were meant to meet.
Look, baby.
I mean, she has her own men, doesn't she? She has so many men. Let her leave my own alone. For me. Please.
Baby. I understand the way you feel, okay? But she didn't ask me for the money, okay? I just give her the money out of my own free will. Yes.
Yeah. You had to give her 200,000 naira. Not even 2,000 or 3,000 for her to recharge her phone.
Baby, it shows how much I value you, okay? It shows how much I love you. I mean, it was no big deal for me to give just 200,000 naira to the girl that hooked us up in gratitude. I mean, it's nothing for you to worry about. Please.
Listen, Cleo has so many men. She has lots of them. I have just you. Do you understand? Now she should take her men sucking fingers off my man and just leave me alone. Now you've gone to squander all that money on her. If I ask you to give me money now, you tell me you're broke.
Oh, baby, please snap out of this mood, okay? I mean, look at me, baby. This mood isn't good for you. Honestly, it's not good for you. Please, smile for me. Smile for me, baby. Please smile for me. I'm sorry, okay?
It's okay.
Let's drink something to take you out of this mood, okay? Please. Is any of the girls that squawk with you around? And then get us something to drink.
Nicole is in. Nicole!
I'm sorry.
Nikki!
Yeah, hi Nicole, how are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Cindy, you called me.
Yeah, get the champagne from the fridge in my room.
Okay.
Baby, look at me. Are you better now?
I'm trying to be.
Sure.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, okay?
It's okay.
I'm sorry.
No! No, Matt, it's not proper. Oh, so because she's dating you now, nobody can be close to you again.
Cleo!
It's up to you to call her to order or advise her or do what when she's going wrong. It's up to you. Well, if you say so, then you're not a man. I'm not insulting you, Matt. I'm just telling you the truth. So because you're sleeping with a woman, she has suddenly become the lord and master of all your decisions. You must do everything to please her. This is not you talking. This is not the matter I know. If you want to drop, no problem. This conversation is not even getting us anywhere.
Can you imagine?
Cleo, what's wrong?
If I tell you what Cindy did today, you won't believe it.
Which Cindy? The one that works at the bank.
Who else? Man, that girl is not my friend, though. We babes, we're bad. We seize every opportunity to gossip, to envy each other, to lie, to quarrel. What is it?
Oh, you didn't know. Men are better with friendship, bro. Look at me now. You are the only female friend I have. Abeg, tell me, what did Cindy do, Jerry?
It's a long story. You know, apart from the funny, funny way she's been behaving since she met Matt, man, that girl, she is so greedy. She is so jealous. Just because Matt gave me money today, she's been raising hell and brimstone ever since.
I beg, ignore her. Is she crazy? Collect more money from Matt. Who introduced her to him?
Ask me. I haven't even finished yet. Yes, babe. That I should divide the money 50-50. That's her boyfriend that gave it to me.
And tells me, hi. I don't blame her. She's now a madam. She works in a bank and she's dating Matt, who I introduced to her. So she doesn't know who the big chicks are on this estate anymore. Hey, God.
You are short. Cleo, I am short. I am short, to say the least. So, it has come to this, eh? Cleo, I think I should go and confront her right away.
Please, tell her some home truth for me. I'll be watching you guys from here because if I go near that idiot in my present mood, I will bury somebody's child alive.
Cindy! Cindy!
Cindy! Can I help you?
Yes, you can help me. What I've come to ask you is that since when have you become so full of yourself in this neighborhood? How much is your salary? That you no longer respect the big chicks in this estate anymore?
I will answer that question. You want to know how much my salary is, right?
Well, my salary is enough
to buy a million cartons of body spray for idiots like you who go around town polluting the atmosphere with your horrible, terrifying body odor. I can't even breathe. Can you girls breathe?
No!
Now that I've given you an answer to your question, could you get your stupid self and get out of my sight so I can drive my car away? Look, just step aside because you don't even have a car of your own. Now, one last thing. Next time, don't you ever stop me on the road to ask me stupid questions about my job or my salary. Because, my dear, you have never gotten a job before. Neither have you received anything called a legit salary before. Is that understood?
I have a job. You, employer of that, your distressed bank. Look, don't insult me again, though. Don't insult me again, though. Because if you do, I'll just get physical with you.
just stay
off Leo's path. That is all I came to tell you.
Don't cry. She's gonna cry. Wait, you say you have a job. Which job? Is it Akuna Kuna or Rons?
Are those jobs?
Let me give you a word of advice, my dear. Go and pass simple school set before you come and talk to me again next time. Because for somebody like you to talk to me, it's a very big insult. And if you try it again, I will not take it from you. Is that understood?
Wait, let me ask that. What is it about, what's her name? Leo, whatever she's called. Why did she come herself? What are you? Are you her mom?
I beg, shut up. Who called you into this? Squatter!
Hey, Jennifer, if I'm a squatter, I'm in my own cousin's house. I wonder why you're in closer, especially as we all know you have no blood ties with her.
What else can this piece
of rubbish be?
She's the original squatter. We came to S-Q-A-T-T-E-R.
My dear, how much is the house in this town? Come on, do you know? Have you bet before? This girl!
Thunder! We fire all of you in this estate! Just get ready, y'all! It is me against you!
What did they say to you now? What happened?
Cleo, let's go. Let's go.
Let's go.
Give me.
We show up.
We
really show them today.
Oh, God. Man, you really gave her the striking side of your tongue.
But you know me now. You know that I show no mercy when it comes to things like that.
Wait
a minute. Who the hell is Cleopatra? Or is it that one they call Jennifer? Look at those ordinary dusters. Those rags that men in this city used to wipe their shoes. They think they can look at Cindy in the face and talk to me anyhow they like. We'll show them.
At that point, I started feeling sorry for her. She wanted to cry.
Hey, but I would have been happier if Cleopatra had come herself. Hey, that borehole, I would have washed her clean with my mouth.
Jeez, Cindy, don't you ever run out of coinages. Which one is borehole again?
With all the men that girl sees, you want to tell me you don't know what she looks like under the skirt?
Oh, yes!
You know me now, my mouth has no break when it comes to those kind of things, when I'm being provoked. You know most of these girls that have grown up on the streets. You know?
Yeah.
They've lived all their lives on the streets, they've not been to school, and then they now make small one naira coins the rough way. Mostly on their backs, you know how it is. They
think they have the worst words than those of us who were brought up in proper homes and who have sound education. I will surprise them.
You're too bad. Don't mind them.
Matt, I want you to stop seeing Cindy. I want you to break up with that ingrate. Jennifer, come and sit down. It's not Matt that insulted you. Eh? Come and sit down and leave it to me now. Did you hear what I just said?
I'll pretend I didn't hear you.
No, you will not pretend you didn't hear me because I'm not joking. I think the little money you're giving her, added to the little money she's earning at the bank, has gone to her head, up to the point of challenging me. Look at Jennifer here. There is no name in this world Cindy did not call her yesterday just because Jennifer stood up for me and told her to stop insulting me.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying dump her. I will introduce you to another chick, somebody who is prettier and more fun to be with.
Okay, let me ask you. What makes you think you have such power and authority over me? Okay? To decide who I pick or who I dump. Oh, because you introduced me to her, right? Let me tell you, if that's the impression you have, it will not work. You know why? Do you know why? Let me tell you why. Because I have a mind that is entirely my own.
Me?
Yes, you.
Matt. And since when did you start talking to me like this? Because of Cindy you got to know just yesterday. You want to lose my friendship. Matt, have you forgotten that I knew you when you were nothing? When you had no cover to your name? Matt, I know how you made money. I know the man I made you.
Beautiful speech. Do me a favor. Go to hell. If you invited me to your house to tell me to leave Cindy, then you deserve to be told to go to hell. And you know what? I'm going to tell her everything. I'm leaving.
So you won't do as I say?
No, I will not.
Cleo, leave him. Leave him. I actually thought you were a man. But I think I know better now. Go.
You. You. Well, I don't have anything to say to you. And now to you, Cleo. If you will excuse me, I've got work to do.
Fine! Go! Run to Cindy. Embrace her in love and be happy. But the days are coming.
Cleo, are you threatening me?
No. I only said the days are coming. Oh. It's not a threat, it's reality.
Okay. All right. Bring it on. I'll be waiting.
Can you imagine? Max! Small Max!
You know, men are like babies. They follow the woman whose breast they're sucking. What did you expect? He's not sleeping with Cleopatra. It's Cindy he's sleeping with, so why would he listen to me?
You are the treasure that I seek. You were close to me and I did not know.
What do you want?
I just called you to tell you that I'm still with Matt. Matt is still here with me. He did not leave me as you begged him to. I'm sorry to bust the bubble. You know, he's still here with me and there is nothing you can do about it.
Baby, it's not necessary.
Let me tell her. You know, I want her to know that I know everything she's been scheming so she doesn't think that I don't know.
Sweetie.
Simply because I found that my boyfriend was spending some hard-earned money on waste products at home.
Sweetie, it's not necessary.
Cindy, I heard that. I'm a waste product, not so. No problem. I'm not a parrot like you. But by the time I finish showing you, we'll know who's a waste product put into us. Hmm?
Anyways, that's not necessary, okay? Like I was saying before you rudely interrupted me, Matt's darling is still here with me. Listen, I'm sure you're going to hear me kiss him. Did you hear that? I'm sorry. You know, he's still here with me. We are so in love. All your antics, your dirty antics, it's not enough to break us out. Hello? Oh, she got the phone.
Baby, that wasn't necessary now.
It was really necessary. Don't worry, let me call her again.
Hey, what is ringing? Pick it up.
It's Cindy. She's insulting me again. But I will show her. I will show that girl.
What is all this?
Don't worry yourself. Why are you worrying? You know me, Jennifer. I'm a cool oppressor. I don't believe in talking too much.
Big cop now. It's just one little one I want to say to her. Don't worry, Kiki.
Patricia, my darling. How did you find me?
Trust me.
Ah, good to see you.
Good to see you
too. As you can see, I'm taking a problem in the pool.
I prefer hotel pools, especially when I'm trying to run away from home.
I know.
I hope everything is okay.
Everything is not okay. One of the boys you made is stepping on my toes so badly. And I will do anything for you to deal with him for me.
Which of my boys?
Matt.
Matt? It has to do with a woman, not so. Yeah, he's not my babe once.
Yes, it has to do with a woman. How did you know?
That boy. Because Matt is very stupid, especially when it comes to women. What has he done this time?
He has taken sides with one small-time babe to insult me. A babe I hooked him up with.
And what do you want me to do?
Big John, I want you to block all his means of making money. Let me see where he'll be getting money to be given to that idiot to compete with me.
What if I refuse?
Big John, you won't refuse me. I know you have a soft spot for me. Please, for me.
You know what I want. I've been telling you for years.
Me?
Yes. You.
Book a hotel room and I'll be with you tonight.
Ah. Fine. Fine. Then consider Matt taken care of. I will strangulate his flow of cash. I come to think of it, I have had issues with him for years. You know I hate him.
Big John, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Book a hotel room, let me know the room number and I'll be with you tonight.
I'll do just that.
Oh, I have to run.
That's okay.
I will see you tonight.
That's my lady. Hello? Bruce, get me all the details of accounts operated by Matt in all the banks. Do it immediately.
FCC. You are wanted at the station for questioning, sir.
For what? I mean, I have no skeletons in my cupboard. Why?
My friend, we have concrete evidence pointing to the fact that not only are you involved in 419, but you're also guilty of money laundering.
Me?
We have details of your fraudulent business deals abroad. We have names, dates, and addresses. Arrest this man.
Yes, sir.
Hey, wait. Look, officers, I appreciate the good work you guys are doing, okay? But honestly, man, look, me, Matt, money laundering. Hell no, no, not me, man. Let me just call my lawyer, okay?
My friend, don't waste my time. We have orders to bring you to the office in handcuffs. The evidence against you is overwhelming. Let's get to the office. You can now call your lawyer. Pick him.
Yes, sir. Yusuf!
Oga! Oga?
Who is Yusuf?
Yusuf is my cook. Yusuf.
Oga.
Take care of my house till I return, alright?
My friend, that will not be possible for us to have orders to seal off these premises. And more of my men are on their way to do just that. So Yusuf and your other household staff cannot stay here. Mr. Matt, we also happen to know about your latest bank fraud in Dubai. So, you see, maybe from here to jail. So, move it.
Yes, sir. Move it. Hey.
Wait. Officer, who did this to me? Officer, wait! Officer, who betrayed me?
Wait, stop asking silly questions.
That the girl's friends turn to my worst enemy. Oh Lord, oh Lord, help me. I gave you my heart, I gave you my trust. Now you have my back.
Cindy, what's the matter?
It's Matt.
Matt? What about Matt? Has he suddenly taken ill?
I got a call. Somebody called me and said that Matt has been arrested by EFCC.
My God!
I don't know, apparently somebody must have got some evidences against him, you know, and reported him to the EFCC.
Is it that bad? Does he know who set him up?
He doesn't know. He doesn't know. That is the problem now, you know? Although he is suspecting one or two of his business rivals, but there's no strong evidence against anyone. So we don't know who the person is. Mega, if Matt goes to jail, what will happen to me? Eh? What will happen? What will I do now?
No. Matt won't go to jail. He has connections.
Connections?
Connections.
With EFCC. Those ones that even arrest governors. Please, say something else. This is not good for me now. This is not good for my rep in this estate now. This is not good. How much?
I hope you are cool, and I hope your darling Matt
He's holding you in his arms right now, and you're kissing him back just like the other day, and generally having a swell time.
What? Who was that?
Who? It's Cleopatra.
What?
Oh, God.
This is small.
Cleopatra again? Could it be she has a hand in this?
I don't know, but it is not impossible.
If not, I mean, how come she had so fast?
See, my life, I have just become a laughing stock for my enemies because of Matt. God. Well, it is not who laughs first that laughs the longest. It is who laughs last. Go and get me my diary.
Okay. If they think they can mess up with Max,
too bad they cannot succeed with me. Let her try me. Nonsense.
Hurry up now, what is it? What is keeping you there?
Okay now. The battle line has been drawn. Let's see how well this will take us to. Nonsense.
My dear, I'm on the street having fun. I know you've been crying for months, your darling boyfriend. So I've brought you a very big bedsheet. Cut it into 1,000 pieces of handkerchiefs and wipe your eyes well, well. You hear?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going. Before you say that, I did not come to sympathize with you when EFCC arrested your boy Red.
Abio, we are good friends and we act like good friends.
Get this rag out of here.
Has done. No. We have to hit her where it hurts her most.
That is exactly what I intend to do. You don't understand.
Oh, gosh. What exactly do you have in mind?
Cruel's mother lives somewhere in Onan Street, right?
Yes.
I know that she and Glo has a very close relationship. And Glo would do anything to keep that relationship. I will expose Glo. And will open her nakedness to her mother, to the entire world. Her mother was a real good bachelor.
Hey! Who do we have here? Madam Singh.
I hope you haven't come here to make your hair because all the dryers in this salon are going to be paid for by me right away and reserved for me whether I use them or not.
Hello? Who is the dog back in? Wait, did somebody just say something? What was that? A noise coming from some animal?
Animal, eh?
Okay.
Jennifer.
Yes, ma'am.
Give me 50,000 naira from my bank. Give it to Madam Abigail. Madam Abigail.
Huh?
I am paying you 50,000 naira to rent all the hair dryers in this salon. Let some people take their sorry and smelly and shameful selves out of this salon to another salon to do their hair.
Yes. Oh, God, how foolish. Madam Abigail, please. Hmm? Tell one of your girls to come and attend to me. Ignore all these jobless girls around town. You know how they are.
Hey! Sandy, I'm sorry, oh. Since Cleo has booked for all the dryers, there's nothing I can do.
Did you hear her?
No, did you hear her? You daughter of Eve. Mm-hmm.
Abe, just... Abe, go. Really? Oh, Madam Abigail, so money now controls you, right? No. Don't worry. He wants money. I will give you money. Okay? Hello? Nicole? Hi, are you home? Oh, you're not? Shit. Don't worry, I wanted you to get me like 100 grand from the house. But it's okay, don't worry, I'll sort myself out.
Come here, Getman. Is your Getman not there to bring the 100,000 naira cash for?
Here is a check for 100,000 naira. Now I have paid for this salon for 3 hours. I want everybody to get out, except those that I choose to stay. Cleopatra, now you get your stinking self and walk out of that door. No, you're not exempted, okay? So get your overused self out of this place.
For what? For check, paper. Madam Abigail, let her pay you 100,000 naira cash and I will leave this place for her.
All of you should stop this nonsense. There's no need for all this. Eh? Let's behave like mature people here. Oh, you just hold it right there. This is how it is, right? Because it is now my turn. You were talking about maturity. When she gave you 50,000 naira and asked me to leave, did you talk about maturity? No, because it is now my turn. Abi? Or because you think you're closer to her, whatever.
Yes. Madam Abigail, check Abi. 100,000 naira check, eh? This wristwatch is worth over 600,000 naira.
Madam Abigail, I am renting your whole salon for 2 days.
Hey!
Cindy, this salon belongs to me for 2 days and I don't want you here. Oh yeah. Outside. Hey. Halele!
Outside. Get out! Go!
Go now!
Was a joke.
No?
I mean, everybody knows the two of you as friends. It is not a joke, Madam Abigail. It's called beef. Hey! Cindy!
Cindy, please, come and do your hair. Cindy! Cindy! Cindy, please come back, eh?
I thought the whole thing was a joke. Please! Hey, come back now. Come and do your hair.
Hello.
Ah, good morning. I have Guardian, Punch, Vanguard, even this day. Which one should I do?
We have not really come to buy a newspaper, but we've come to change your life a little bit.
Change my life?
Mm-hmm. So, because he's going to pay you much.
Yes, Tony.
Tony.
Stop now.
Market
don't finally come.
I knew here. They said they want to change my life.
We should talk business now. I don't understand. You should buy. You know that you haven't sold anything to me. I don't understand you.
Excuse me. Are you interested or not?
Come with us. It will pay you.
Okay. No problem. Tony,
you don't come out.
Just look after this
business. I hope it's for business. Anyway.
Then better.
Okay. Make it good news, bro. Make it something today. I'm around.
Here's the vendor here, Chandler.
Good evening.
I have a job for you. I will pay you 70,000 naira for the job. I'm going to give you everything you need for the job. I'll get you a car to drive, buy you clothes to wear. But like I said, after everything, I'll give you 70,000 naira. Are you ready to work?
What kind of job, auntie?
Sit down. Relax.
Yes, auntie.
Look, cut out that anti-bullshit. You need a rugged and confident attitude towards women to be able to do the kind of job that I want to give to you. Okay?
Okay.
Neka.
Yeah?
Get him a bottle of red wine.
Okay.
Red wine! It's red wine for me.
I just want to see your composure. Relax.
No problem. I'm relaxing. Red wine.
Okay.
Tony,
cool down. Nick, I don't follow you. You don't go to Fabi.
Tony, cool down now. Wait, let me explain. Give you.
No police go come. No police go come. Man, go down.
I know still. Just maintain first. Make I come out.
Cool down.
Just wait.
Now, wow. I don't follow you. I don't have to take up, no. How come this fine chief? I need this fine chief.
Cool down, man.
What is it? What
are they embarrass me now?
What did they say they go chief now?
No, they shout like mama. Wait first, make I tell you how this chief take form.
Ah, I fear now.
Wait. Come now. Don't be still. Cool down. Come.
What's going to happen now?
Wait. something happened. Eh? I need you to do me a favor. Hmm? I will give you taxi money. Mm-hmm. Hmm? There is a woman I want you to help me follow. For a few days. See, the person who gave me this jeep, who bought me this place, paid me 70,000 naira.
70,000 naira?
I will give you 10,000 for you.
70,000 is enough money.
Hey now.
But the problem is, which kind of job? As in, I don't understand. Which kind of job?
Get into the car. This is not something we can discuss.
Police, catch us. You know you cannot fight this kind of thing. That's
your problem. Don't get embarrassed.
I don't enter. Enter, please. Enter.
Okay, fine. I will enter. Just enter. Enter.
Ah, wow. Oh. This is not true. Don't tell me it's true. We are going there. And then.
That's her car there. I saw her go into the shopping mall. She must be there somewhere around.
That's Are you car. Sure?
I'm very sure, Nick. Very, very sure. See, I followed her in a taxi, and as she stepped in, I rushed to call you.
So what do I tell her?
See you, Nick. Are you even stupid or something similar? Eh? See, you're missing the 70,000 naira if you don't watch it. Okay, I'll help you. You know what? You send me to hand, I'll call her for you. Yes.
And if she comes, then I tell her what?
Ah, for Christ's sake. Okay, do you not say they told you she lacks more than everything? Even her own life?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Then you speak the language of money to her. You know, you can tell her she's beautiful, tell her you like her, you know, tell her you want to give her some treat. Then promise her some amount of money, like 1 million. Bingo! I'm telling you! She's the one, she's the one. Please, let me get her, Nick. Let me get her.
Good day, Auntie. Good day, Auntie. Please forgive me if I start with you. My chief sent me to call you.
Your chief?
Yes, Auntie.
Who is your chief?
He's in that jeep over there.
Well, if he wants to talk to me, he should come here and talk to me.
Oh, no, Auntie, please. You know, does this thing dog this big man with too much money? Chief will kill me. He'll definitely kill me if I don't bring you to him. Please, for my own innocence sake, just see him. But even if you say no to him, he won't blame me for that. Please, Auntie.
What's his name?
He's Chief Nixon Pekedremo. He's an oil chief, oil magnate from Ijoland. Please, Auntie, please.
All right, let me see him.
Thanks a lot, Auntie. Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry, my assistant kept you on the side. Can you come inside? I promise I'll turn on the AC for my sake and chill out, okay?
Now you have my back, up against the world, but even-
Well done. You have earned your money. Nicole! Nikki!
Yeah.
Please hurry up with the money. House and never come back. I don't know you. I've never met you before. But you don't know me. Is that clear?
I know.
One more thing. I hope she doesn't know that the dollars you gave her were fake.
You mean the $8,000 that I paid her?
Yeah.
No, she doesn't have any idea. It's like the light in the room was dim and she left as soon as I paid her. She had no reason to suspect they were fake.
Beautiful. So, you get going.
Yeah. And I'll be coming the next time you have a job like this.
I always know who to call.
Bye.
So, Cindy. What's next? Keep our fingers crossed, because Cleo is about to burn.
Girls, come on. Congratulate me now. Not too much. You
match. Give me five, please.
Don't worry. By the time we are done with that girl, she will run out of this night.
Money, madam.
Money, how
you? You want them for dollar, euro, dollars. Avela pounds?
Dollars.
Yes. Okay, you are
Idris, sir, now what is it?
$1,000.
You are.
Ah, madam, let you come inside.
No, no, I'm in a hurry. Please bring me the money here. Bring me equivalent of $2,000 in naira.
Ah, madam, no problem. The dollar don't fall. The thing there, 126 naira now.
Bring them like that.
Ah, where your calculator?
You go for your pocket, you know.
Yes.
Pocket.
Yeah. $2,000 go give us 252,000 naira. You are. Hurry up. Madam, wait till they come.
Hurry, please.
Yewa, madam, now the money be this, eh? Count and they sure say it complete.
Okay. Here, this one complete too, $2,000.
Thank you. Yeah. Now go there, eh?
Yeah. I hope that this money complete.
They correct, correct. You heard the do while you're here. $2,000 fake dollars you give me. I like it. See,
Wallahi talahi, I will deal with you. Gaskia?
Who gave you fake dollars? My friend, will you stop lying?
You want to kaput my business? You want to mess up my business? Eh?
How about madam? How come? You gave off fake dollars? Shut up, two.
Are you sure we can?
Shut up, two of you. Shut
that
up.
Brubaka.
Come on, then.
Shut up, Brubaka.
Hey,
Okay.
Oga, okay. Oga.
Alhaji, don't worry. I will arrest Alhaji. Don't worry, Alhaji. Okay.
No.
I'm okay.
DPO. I've never been so embarrassed in my whole life before. Those men nearly stripped me naked, even not for the policeman on duty there. But what I've told you is the truth. I don't print fake dollars. I only did business with a customer who paid me in dollars. I didn't know they were fake.
So, what kind of business? And where is the customer now? Can you get him for us?
I've been trying his number since morning and he's been saying not available. He must have changed his number knowing he gave me fake dollars.
So what kind of transaction did you have with him?
I sold him... something.
You sold things to him? What are the things?
My diamond studded ring. I saw him at the supermarket and he said he liked my ring, that I should sell it to him. He begged me to sell it to him. I agreed because I always go to Italy to buy things to sell. There and then, he paid me in dollars, gave me his number and drove away. I don't know this man from anywhere now. I don't know him.
This is a very serious offense that can attract many years of imprisonment if charged to court.
I know. DPO, I know. Please now. Have pity on me. I've been dragged up and down since morning. Please.
Okay, okay, okay. Stop crying. I will not take you to court. Based on human sympathy and my personal conviction. But you must have to be very careful. Next time, do not accept payment in foreign currency without first confirming the authenticity of the note. Do you understand that?
DPO, thank you. Thank you. God will bless you. Thank you.
Okay. You just have to be very careful. That's all.
Good morning. Okay. Please, I'm here to see Miss Cleopatra. She has parcels. I need to sign and collect them.
Okay, you can give them to me.
No, I was instructed not to give it to someone else.
Okay. Hold on, let me go and call her.
All right. Good morning, Auntie.
Morning.
We have parcel.
On my way to work, I decided to stop by and make sure that my parcels get to you personally. Those are four full cartons of cotton wool. Use them to clean the blood dripping down your eyes because I know you've been crying blood since the fake dollar incident. Oh, darling, I'm so sorry. I feel your pain. I know what you're going through, but I'm sure you can handle it. Okay? Take it easy. Sort is life. Let me tell you something. It is not over yet. Now, by the time I am done with you, when you hear sin, you will run. You will run so fast, you will not wait to hear D.
Ah, what? What is it?
Cindy.
What did she do? What is Cindy do now? What?
Hey!
What happened? What did Cindy do now?
She sent me packs of cotton wool to clean my eyes.
Why?
She knows I've been crying blood. She was the one that set me up with Nixon and the fake dollars.
Ha! Hey.
Nixon had me for free, Jennifer. Oh, sir. Oh, sure, free.
Cindy will never go free for this. Cindy will never go free for this. Hey!
Cindy, I decided to be humble and I asked Madame Abigail to invite you to her salon because she won't open your gate for me if I come to your house. I've called you here for peace. I'm tired of all this fighting and beef we have for each other. I mean, we used to be best of friends. What are we really fighting for? This is of no use. Look, I want us to end this all here now and become friends again. That's why I told Madame Abigail to invite you to her salon.
Cindy, you've just heard what Cleo has said. We've all lived in this estate for years. You see, both of you are like my younger ones. Not just because you come here to do your hair, but because we are close. Sometimes when you have problems, you confide in me. Please, I want the both of you to be friends again. Cindy, what do you have to say?
Well, if she says she's tired of fighting me and wants to be my friend again, and she knows she's sincere about it. Okay, no problem. I'm all for friendship.
Don't cry. I'm sorry for everything.
It's okay. I'm sorry too. I really am. Come here.
Hey. Cleo and Cindy are friends again. See, before two of you leave this place, two of you should buy me wine.
Don't worry, but I'm gonna pick up real. So, how have you been?
Very well.
You look nice.
Thanks. You too. I like this. You thought this is the last time we traveled together, right?
Yes, you remember. Are you on your way home from here?
I'm just gonna stop by, buy one or two things.
We can go together. And play and
really?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sure Nicole will be very surprised.
Well, that's how life is.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll get my bag.
It's okay.
I had to swallow my.